Hey everybody, it's Dan Dannemuller out here with Edmo's. We're out here fishing in a media day for Crappie Masters. Wanted to share with you about something electronics wise that is just really slicker and slicker and slicker. And that is the new Garmin electronics that's out in today's world. And they have really, really set the bar for the other companies to compete against. The accuracy and ability of these units is unbelievable. We've been using them now a year. We started with the 1040 XS's, which is basically 11-inch screen. And they are so detailed and give so many different options than the other machines out there now give. It's unbelievable. Here's some of the things to look for and why it's been so important to us. We were up at Truman Lake, fishing Truman Lake last year, among other lakes. We went out on that lake, and always on the other units that we used, all we saw was red globs on the bottom, which we had to believe were trees with fish in them that were laying over from when the forests were still there. Well, what we found was when we brought these units up there, we actually saw the trees and the limbs laying over on the bottom, where we could see the fish within the trees, and we could tell what trees had fish on them, ones did not, and you could see the trunks to them. At another point in time, I was taking people out for Mark's Outdoors in Birmingham last June, and over 150 people went out with me on the water to go out and see the electronics as well as ride in the boat. Everybody wanted to see the Garmin, so they took me places to look at their structure they had put in the water. Several guys showed me, and this is a specific one, where I saw a big oak, I mean they drug it with a rope, they told me, that was probably close to 30, 40 feet long and had forks in it. And it was actually showed that limb down on the bottom, and near it they had concrete with limbs out of the concrete buckets, and they had those placed strategically around that particular tree, and it was holding all those fish in there. And when the guys saw it, they said, "You got to keep this electronics away from my area because it shows too much detail." Another one that we went to, we put it on Beaver Lake up in Arkansas last year and fishing that tournament, pre-fishing it. Garrett and I went into this one creek, and it's a big creek near Marina, and we started through there just doing down view and side view. And down view is where you're looking very concentrated on the bottom, and side view is very concentrated out away from the boat. And immediately we found two boats laying on the bottom. One of them was put down there on purpose because it was a John boat sitting upright, and within it, it had two concrete buckets in it with limbs out the top of it, one front and aft of the boat. And you could actually see them sitting up in there. No fish on it, but they were down there. Then down from that was a semi-V boat that was turned on its side, and you could actually see the outline of it laying on the bottom, and it was just no more than about 100 yards off of the other boat. Unbelievable stuff, so much detail. And we've done it over and over and over again where we've seen the fish on these units, and it really shows them in the grass. It shows them where they're highlighted in the grass or in heavy structure, and then you can pinpoint those brush piles where those fish are. Instead of looking all red, they actually show all the limbs and everything else using their high-powered chirp that's within the GCV-10. What's so cool about these two, there's other capabilities on these things that give you all kinds of ways and waypoints and tracks where you can put all the details in about it on a alphanumeric keypad that we never had before, and being able to go and enter the information you want on that unit. On the side view, and I can say this legally, the lawyers have cleared this, it is the best side view and down view in the industry. Why? It's a true left and right, and it does not do a composite of the pixels between them. It doesn't estimate them. It actually gives the defined pixels of what's down there. It gives you that detail. If you take a look at the transducer in the back end of my boat, you'll see that thing is extremely long because it has more plates in it, so it can pick up more details of what is in the water surrounding you. And it goes on and on and on, the capabilities. But I want to share a couple of things with you that are so important to us out here on the water. And I know they're important to you as crappie fishermen and bass fishermen, but especially crappie fishermen. We want to see all those details down there and how the fish are relating to the structure that keeps us in the fish. Well, anyway, go try you a Garmin. You can't go wrong. They're priced about the same as the other units. They're coming out with touchscreens on the big units this year. And the next week, they're due out the 7612 series. Check them out. This is Dan Damula with crappie.com for Mr. Ed Mose and Crappie Now magazine. You guys have a great day.